everybody. Today we have with us IMPA member Sujata Sharma, a counselor, soft skill trainer, and image consultant who has worked with corporates like Convergys, Honeywell, and T-Systems. She has been training and mentoring for NGOs and organizations, and also visiting the faculty of MIT University Pune for corporate grooming. Hi, Sujata.
Hi, Nikita. Thank you for having me.
Most welcome. So, Sujata, today we would like to know about your journey into stepping into the image consulting profession until now. So, we would like to know what made you excited about stepping into the image consulting industry.
Sure. Wow, this is one of my favorite, Nikita. I was a working professional way back in 2003 to 2005, and then I took a break and then I was now looking for a comeback, and three things which always fascinated me was people, clothes, fashion, and people's person. You might say that I am a total people's person. I love to listening stories. I love to get inspired by people. And being a counselor, I had been doing it for quite some time, but I also had that inclination towards, you know, fashion, clothes, and why, what, how of fashion? Why are people making certain choices they make in fashion? Why do they dress up in a certain way? So, and I used to, you know, observe people. So it was always an inclination I had towards this field. And then I also wanted to work like my own boss, my own timings, something which I wanted to do on my will. So all of these things, you know, they pushed me towards something which then I found was an amalgamation of whatever I was looking all the while. And that's how image and soft skills happened with me.
Wow. So how did you get to know about the image consulting profession?
Yeah, like I mentioned, I always had it somewhere back of my mind. But then to get a direction, how to go about it, then like you start doing your research, and I did the same thing. I started, you know, finding out how to go about it, what is the scope, where to go about it. And doing that research, it landed me at the right place, I would say the right time. And I am here right now with you, and I landed up in ICBI, and that has been a major this thing for me. It's very important you be at the right time or place at the right time so that you get a direction. So that is exactly what happened to me, because I knew what I was looking for. So when you know what you're looking for, you start looking in the right direction.
Lovely.
Yeah.
So we would love to know, what is your past background?
Okay, yes. I had been a corporate trainer. I was into voice and accent training. I worked for Convergys, Honeywell. That was in 2003 I started my career. And then I also worked in the hospitality industry for some time, where I was grooming the front office staff. And then obviously then priorities shift, and I just took a break from my career, though I was doing a lot of training and mentoring for a lot of NGOs all the way. But as a career, as a full-fledged profession, somewhere it was all backseat. And then now I then again got back into the grid. So now I'm a qualified counselor. I'm doing a lot of counseling for people. And also now I've got into soft skills image. And I am also, like you said, visiting faculty for MIT for their corporate grooming program. And I've designed their entire next semester session for them, what all they need to know. So that's majorly about it.
Okay. So Sujata, why do you think image consulting and soft skills is the most lucrative profession of the decade?
Okay. Yes, image consulting and soft skills are two things which involve people. And this is a concept, here we are now using a term image, but this is a concept which has been there since 1970 and 75. The first book which came out in image was 1975 in US. It was, I think Dress for Success. It was the first book. So this concept had always been there, but here the awareness is now, it's now come up with people. And it's very, very lucrative, because this is one thing which is not going to be stagnant. Because when you are training people, when you are having one-on-one consultations or getting clients, you will never have two people with the same issues or two clients with the same requirements. and that growth that will continuously happen. You have a lot of potential market. 90% of people around here needs image and soft skills. So this is going to be, it's all about, you know, where you tap it, where you create that opportunity, it's all around you. And it's never going to saturate at a point. It's always going to grow, because when people are involved, they always want to grow. They always want to, you know, come out as a polished people. They want, and it's all inside out. So it's so much of work with human behavior. So as long as people are there, this field is always going to be and it's an upcoming field right now. And the way it is picking up, the awareness which is coming. So it's got a lot of potential in the coming years. Lot of potential.
Absolutely. So rightly said, Sujata. So now, since you have stepped into the image industry and into this profession, tell us about the kind of work you're doing.
Okay. Like I said, I am with a lot of corporates. Majorly, I get hired for grooming of the younger lot, the young adults, in terms of their corporate presence, the executive presence. And that also involves a lot of soft skills, which go hand by hand, and body language and all that. So I'm doing a lot of work in that. With T-Systems, I conducted 3 batches, which were picked up from campus. And then we, trained them for a good 20, 30 days, and then made them corporate ready. So major of my work goes this way. And then, as you said, I also go to MIT as a visiting faculty for the corporate grooming. So again, there also we put a lot of emphasis on their corporate presence, the executive presence, the need for body language and soft skills in terms of communication, verbal, non-verbal, and your business communication, your assertiveness. So all of these things, you know, right now I'm focusing on these, building up on these. And that's my major line of work. Besides this, I'm doing a lot of counseling also, which is majorly pertaining to emotional support. So that is my another passion, which I keep following.
Wonderful. So what is the level of awareness amongst corporate about image consulting and soft skills?
Well, like I mentioned, if I say frankly, I started working in 2003. So we always, when we are working in corporates or in organizations, they always look for that, you know, betterment of a person in terms of performance, the language. But that term as such, image consulting, that was not being used so frequently that time. But now I see a shift from those 10, 12 years. Now, mostly all of the corporates are very aware of this, and they emphasize on the importance of this. That's why we are pulled out to train them. And not just, they know the importance of, you know, image, not just at the grassroots level, but they also know as they grow, it becomes even more important how you conduct yourself, how you are coming across, you know. So that is why they are also, not just the hires from campus are getting into this, even people in leadership roles, you know, they're taking it very seriously. So they are very, very aware, and there's a lot of potential in corporates and organizations if we're looking at image or soft skills there.
Absolutely. So last question we would like to know from you and about you is, how have you planned your roadmap to success?
Okay, yes. See, here I'll say patience is the key, Nikita, because, you know, when we are working in a profession like this, sometimes it might be overwhelming that, you know, it's not the pace I want. Maybe it's very slow. I'm not getting, you know, the kind of work I would. But again, see, patience. And you need to plan. There are 2 things very important. You need to identify your niche, what you want to do. Because we can't use all 10 fingers at the same time, we're going to get stuck somewhere. So when we say image, when we say soft skills, it's a huge field. And you need to find your niche. You need to build your brand. Like I know I'm into corporate grooming. I know I'm into campus to corporates. I know what people are and what I am comfortable doing with people. So I will build my brand again, you know, around that. So you get your niche, you build your brand, and then you start planning. Like I plan for 5 years, and then I break it into 3 months, you know. How many corporates do I want? And I look at repetitive work, you know, people who would need me again and again. Once I give them a project, and do I get that work again? So that's how I plan my thing, so that it gives me a permanent, you know, group of people who keep giving me work. And I plan that in 5 years, at least I have 25 such good big corporates with me, so that I move ahead where I, wherever I want to be. But that has to be little steps, well planned. And you need to, you know, be very, very clear about the brand, and then you keep expanding. If I have mastered that, okay, I'm into this corporate presence, into body language communication, and then I want to get into leadership trainings, then I get to that. So people, when they look at you, they need to know what exactly are you good at. And once they know, they will approach you for that. And then you can give them on the platter, ki besides this, you know, I can also cater for this, 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 this. So when we present ourselves, so we have to be very clear that on our roadmap, the journey has to be absolutely clear for others to see. Because whatever they see, that will sell. Jo dikhega, wahi bikega. So we can't confuse them with, you know, lot of stuff on the platter. So that's how I have planned breaking it into three months goals. And then, and also upgrading your skills, using your resources, you know, and making your content as per the client requirements. All of this, you know, it comes into play, and it is a regular process which needs to keep happening when you are working. So that's how I plan this journey as of now.
Lovely, Sujata. It's so well thought of, so well planned. And thank you so much for sharing all your insight, your thoughts with us. And I'm sure your journey, your story is going to be an inspiration to many. Thank you once again for being with us, and all the very best to you from IMPA.
Thank you so much, Nikita. Thank you so much.